My relationship with Ra, the sun god. Dear friends, I'd like to share how our relationship began with Ra, the sun god, and myself. I was living in Port Moresby, New Guinea, with my parents, as I was 5 years old when I first knew about Ra. One day the natives were beating their drums like they did most afternoons at the bottom of our garden. I asked them why they were doing the beating of the drums. One of them came forward and bowed in front of me and said, "Of course, we worship the sun god." And I said, "Where? You know, I'm five." He pointed to my head and said, "Ra." I just giggled and ran back inside to tell my dad what had happened. Of course, you can imagine the outcome of that. My dad just laughed and said, "What rubbish." He was a man, he was an engineer of Qantas. So naturally, that was the outcome. There was quite a long spell until I was 13 when we went to Egypt. As my dad being in Qantas, we travelled quite frequently. We visited the pyramids and all I could feel was an immense energy coming from them that I'd never felt before. So I couldn't help myself from holding my arms close in a hugging way. I just felt love. Yet I didn't understand why. Then I actually heard a voice in my head say, "Welcome home," which startled me completely. I looked around to see if there was someone who was playing tricks on me, but no, just my dad telling me I should be writing notes for school like all the other kids instead of hugging bricks. It made no sense because in those days, when I was 13, there was no, you know, there's no fences around, you know, to stop us getting close to the pyramids like there are now. So it's me wondering the whole trip if I could ever hear from that voice again. It was such a warm voice. The whole journey was a whole world trip, actually. It opened my eyes completely because many places I went, I knew. So by this stage, Mum and Dad were calling me Wendy the Witch, and I'm realizing that I had many lives before this one. At age 13, that was quite an eye-opener. Then age 15, I started a career in hairdressing, and I didn't hear a voice, but I became a psychic hairdresser because I received many messages from my clients so easily, not knowing where they were coming from. Looking back, I believe it was Ra channeling them to me, because they just came so easily. I eventually left my career of hairdressing after many years, I must say, and to go on my spiritual path seriously, not knowing exactly where it was going to lead me, as I knew I had a lot of questions, especially about the voice. In the meantime, I went through many lessons and much healing after I married my soulmate, and that is when things finally started to happen. I was so happy within myself than I'd ever been, and we were travelling in a caravan around Australia. And one night, Ra spoke out loud the way he does with the energy he has, and I was asleep, but my dear husband wasn't. He lay awake till morning in shock, till I awoke saying a man was coming out of me last night. Oh my God, such a shock. Like, who was that man coming out of me? Like, you know, I thought you were a woman. Yes, for sure. And I am. I just said, "Look, that's wonderful. Finally, he's going to speak." Then I had to explain a big story about Ra to him. Then he calmed down. As I said, it's just the beginning. I was so thrilled. It's finally So messages came more and more within after that, guiding me now to write meditations and classes with his assistance. He also likes me to have what he calls healing sittings, another name for readings, and must be guidance in every way, as he told me I'm a medium. I was surprised as the readings went just so smoothly in a professional manner, even though I had not done so before, because I've been doing messages for people, readings, but not really doing it in a professional way, just playing with it. Next, he wished for me to teach other people to channel the higher realms with his guidance. And to do this, I was to take 2 students for 9 weeks and train them, which we did with success, with much laughter with Ra, because he's got such a great sense of humor. As he said, you must lighten up and do not take things so seriously, because that is enlightenment. Surrender and allow us to flow through you with no fear. People who have the astral plane come through them is from their own fears, unforgiveness, resentment, and all the negative emotions they have trapped inside of themselves. So the only time it all started happening for me, after a lot of healing, after abuse, 2 failed marriages and a lot of lessons. Ra was messaging within me, to me, learn from them, and when I have important messages to share, they had to put on a recorder. As when I first started with the messages, I was an unconscious trance medium for a few years, till finally I wasn't. Then it was hilarious, because through me, he actually had trouble with some words, which everyone thought was really funny, and it was. It made everyone lighten up. He would say things like, instead of hospital, he would say horsepital. And it sounded funny because really, horsepital. So it's like a pit for all, and it made others. Many other words, which was really funny. I know he has spoken so much via others, and however, that is with me, and we have both grown so much together. Ra's energy is really strong, and if you can feel it when he comes via me, sometimes he is stronger than others depending on my energy. So it's not just when he's feeling strong energy, he's always got strong energy, but sometimes mine's not as strong, you know. So if mine's not as strong, like last week, the last video I put out, mine wasn't quite as strong. So, you know, he with him coming through, yeah, that's an example. It's a good example. So Ra has another position when I wash my hair. As I have a lot of thick, long hair, Ra's rays dry it beautifully every week. Look, my life with Ra has been the other man in my life, which has been so rewarding in every way. He is my teacher, my psychic, my friend, my hairdresser, my spirit guide, all of which I am forever grateful. Give thanks to you, Ra, forevermore. Namaste, Rosalie. And that is my relationship with Ra. Thanks for listening. I hope you enjoyed.